that carabiner has had it, so I think we're going to have to hook out and put a spare one in. Well, we're sailing on. I'll just quickly get that and do that now. And then I know then it's done. And peace of mind. So we're going to hook in there. In that one. I can just see a windy patch coming up. So if we can just get into that, that'll be useful. Some wind. Here we go. That's a bit better. Now we're picking up a bit of speed. Still only making a couple of knots. Barely anybody out on the sound today. You can hear the sheep on the hillsides. The lambs, anyway. We're just coming up now, we're going to put tack in, so around she goes, and hopefully over she comes, underneath, yep, the jib's cleared it, back the jib a bit, and let it out. We'll head over the centre of the sound and then make a tack so that it takes us up past the eastern breakwater. And the passage plan, well, I should have been at eastern breakwater around about now, so I'm about a good way off at the moment. Just clearing the western end of the breakwater. If we don't pick up much wind, I may have to actually change my passage plan and go out that way. Oh, just crossing the wake of a boat which passed ages ago. Okay, wind has practically died. I have to say, sail shape is so much better since I've made these alterations. The throat to clue crease is almost disappearing now, which is really good. So I'm very pleased. And the spars look a lot better now. They've been rounded as well, which was some of the winter work. And as you can see, that arrangement up the top is so much better. It's holding that yard absolutely steady against the mast. No more flogging, no more tipping off to the side or anything like that. So, vast improvements.
Speed at long last. But we are quite a way behind now, almost an hour behind. It's been really fickle coming up there. And I should have changed my passage plan and gone out a lot further over towards Corsand. So, lesson learned.
Okay, let's hope this works. Let's see what happens. Okay, round we go then. Release that one. Pull in that one. And head up a little bit. She's gonna do it. Yes, I think we've been successful. And yep, on the course for Fort Bovey Sand. And if we can run all the way across now, holding this course, the next tack should put us clear of the eastern breakwater all the way out to Tinker Buoy. Not quite an elegant shape when she's on this tack, but it is setting a lot better than it used to. And just coming into view now is Duke Rock Cardinal Buoy. I was supposed to be here at 10:15 from down there, and it's taken me an hour to get from there to here. Oh yeah, the joys of sailing.